Hello again. You know, I don't write songs, but I do write poems, so I'm fascinated with where people get their inspirations. I sometimes have an inkling of where my own ideas come from, but for most of the stuff I listen to, I really have no idea. Except, last summer, I lived in New York, and I took the train to and from work every day. And sometimes, when a train would pull out of the subway stop, it would make a sound like this. And that would ordinarily have been unremarkable to me, except there's a song called Love Is Like a Bottle of Gin by Stephen Merritt, which has the exact same rhythm as that train engine. And so the wheels started turning. You know, Stephen Merritt is from New York. Maybe he was on the train one night and he just got this rhythm into his head. You never know where things really come from, but it's kind of cool to think about. So, today's love song is Love Is Like a Bottle of Gin by Stephen Merritt. Enjoy! It makes you blind, it does you in. It makes you think you're pretty tough. It makes you prone to crime and sin. It makes you say things off the cuff. It's very small, made of glass, and grossly over-advertised. It turns a genius to an ass, and makes a fool think he is wise. It could make you regret your birth, or turn cartwheels in your best suit. It costs a lot more than it's worth, and yet there is no substitute. They keep it on a higher shelf. The older and more pure it grows, it has no color in itself, but it can make you see rainbows. You can find it on the Bowery, or you can find it at Elaine's. It makes your words more flowery. It makes the sunshine, makes it rain. You just get out what they put in, and they never put in enough. Love is like a bottle of gin, but a bottle of gin is not like love. And I know what you're thinking. Char, you've played two Stephen Merritt songs in one love song week. Why don't you mix it up? And my response to that is, are you human? Do you have a soul? That was a beautiful song. Okay, see you tomorrow.